Welcome. In this video, I'll be solving general annuity problems involving calculating future and present values. In general annuities, payments per year and compounding frequency per year could be different. That is, if payments are made quarterly, interest could be compounded monthly or annually. We begin by calculating the future value of $300 invested each month for 15 years at 8.4% compounded semi-annually. For years, we have 15. Payments are made monthly, so PY equals 12. And interest compounded semi-annually means CY is 2. The nominal interest rate is 8.4% or 0.084. Now, the periodic rate for general annuities is calculated using this formula, where I equals IY over CY and C equals CY over PY. So for rate, I'll type equals, open bracket, 1 plus IY over CY, close bracket, to the power of, open bracket, CY over PY, close bracket, minus 1. Enter. N per is the number of payments in annuities, not the number of compounding periods. So it will be years times PY. Enter. The periodic payment here is 300. There is no present value, so we can leave it blank or enter 0. To compute the future value, type equals FV tab rate comma number of periods comma periodic payments comma. The present value and type are in square brackets here, indicating they are optional. In other words, they are set to 0 by default. So if the present value is 0 and payments are made at the end of each period, we can stop here and hit enter. But I'll select the present value here and enter. The future value is negative here because the periodic payment was entered as a positive value. I'm going to double click and make the periodic payment negative. And here we have a positive future value. Next, to calculate the future value assuming payments are made at the beginning of each period, I'm going to copy the future value formula from the address bar and paste it down here. I'll double click the cell and for type, I'll enter 1 for begin mode. Enter. You can see that the future value is larger when payments are made at the beginning rather than at the end. Now, the total amount paid here will be the periodic payment times the number of payments. And the interest earned will be the future value minus the total amount paid. Next, we compute the present value of a general annuity. How much was borrowed at 7.8% compounded daily if repaid with $988 payments every 3 months for 9.5 years? For years, we have 9.5. Payments are made every 3 months, that is quarterly, so PY equals 4. Interest is compounded daily, so CY equals 365. The nominal interest rate is 7.8% or 0.078. Now for the periodic rate, I can copy it from the future value sheet or I can type it here again. Enter. N par is the number of payments, which is years times PY. Periodic payment is 988. The loan will be paid off at the end, so future value is 0. To compute the present value, type equals PV, tab to select, rate, comma, number of periods, comma, then the periodic payment. The future value and type in square brackets here are set to 0 by default. So if I stop here and hit enter, Excel is going to set the future value to 0, and since 0 for type means payments are made at the end of the periods, it will calculate the present value in end mode. Enter. Again, if I want it to show as positive, I can make the periodic payment negative. Now, suppose payments were made at the beginning of the periods, I can copy the present value formula from the address bar, paste here, enter 0 for future value, comma, then 1 for type to indicate begin mode. We see that the present value is higher in begin mode, indicating that the borrower can borrow a slightly higher amount if they wish to repay at the beginning of each period, rather than at the end. The total amount paid is periodic payment times the number of payments. And the interest paid on the loan will be the total repayment amount minus the amount borrowed. And that's it. Thanks for watching.